ओके सो वी विल स्टार्ट विद पेज नंबर 38 पेज नंबर 38 सेकंड पैराग्राफ इन अ डेमोक्रेसी इट इज द पीपल हु इलेक्ट द रिप्रेजेंटेटिव्स एज मेंबर्स ऑफ द लेजिस्लेटिव असेंबली एमएलएस दस इट इज द पीपल हु हैव द मेन अथॉरिटी नाउ दिस पीपल हैव द मेन अथॉरिटी द रूलिंग पार्टी मेंबर्स देन फॉर्म द गवर्नमेंट ruling party is forming the government and some members are appointed ministers so here we can say that who is forming the government ruling party is forming the government and some members are appointed as ministers these ministers are in charge of various departments of the government such as health in the above example so we have various departments if one government is a ruling party then he has to work in various departments and you will see a head of the department or you can say a minister for each and every department whatever work is done by this department has to be approved by the members of the legislative assembly now whatever work these ministers are doing this should be approved by the members of the legislative assembly now here you can see the picture in a democracy people organize meetings to voice their opinions and protest against the government now many people get together and they have problems with certain decisions so they protest against the government and they loudly speak various naras and whatever they want whatever the need is For that, they are just raising their voice. Here we have page number 39. We have new topic, which is a wallpaper project. Now, before we start this topic. You can see the table above. You can see the name of the department that is school education, public works department, and agriculture. So these are the different departments, and you will see the various ministers appointed for the particular department, and examples of their work. So which kind of work they do, that you can write down in the given space. Here we have a topic, a wall. A paper project. What is that? Let us see that. A wallpaper is an interesting activity through which research can be done on particular topics of interest. So it's a kind of activity which research can be done on particular topics. The following photographs explain the different aspects involved in creating a wallpaper in a classroom. Here we are talking about the school, the class, and you can see the pictures. Students are working on the project in a group. After introducing the topic and having a brief discussion with the whole class, the teacher divides the class into groups. Teacher is discussing and then he is dividing the class in a group. The group discusses the issue and decides what it would be like to include in the wallpaper. Children then work individually or in pairs to read the collected material and write their observations or experiences. So here the kind of activity the school students are doing as per the instruction of the teacher. They can also do through creating stories, poems, case studies, interviews, etc. In the second picture, students, I think 4 to 5 students are working together. The group looks at the material that they have selected, drawn and written. They read each other's writing and provide feedback to each other. They make decisions on what should be included and finalize the layout for the wallpaper. So basically they are making the wallpaper in a kind of activity, because you people are also getting the projects from your school, so also these students are working like you only in a group, and just one is drawing something, the other is writing something, other student is giving the ideas. So likewise they are working in a group, they are making a wallpaper project. Okay, now come to the page number 40. You can see the classroom picture. The teacher is standing there and three students are presenting their project which they have made on the chart paper, and they are explaining what they have made, and other students are listening to them, and one by one maybe they are having this wallpaper project activity. Each group then presents the wallpaper to entire class. It is important that more than one member of the group is asked to present, and that each group is allotted the same amount of time to discuss their work. Now see, this is the most basic thing that you people also do, so you are well aware that in a project 3 to 4 people are working together, and one will hold the chart paper, the other will explain whatever they have made or whatever they have explained in the chart paper, or which is your topic, which is the topic. So this way they are explaining, and the particular time is also given to them to explain their work. After each group has presented, it would be a good idea to have a feedback session on the following. So for example, if you have 5 groups, then your teacher will give you the feedback that how was the project, whether it was good or very good or excellent, or which kind of changes you have to make next time. So the task of giving the feedback is of teacher. What more could they do on their own? How could their work be organized better? How could writing and presentation be improved upon? This wallpaper about the 2006 dengue epidemic was prepared by children of class 6B of Kendriya Vidyalaya to Hindon, Ghaziabad, Uttar Pradesh. So this is the project which is made by the 6th standard students of Uttar Pradesh, Ghaziabad school. The name of school is Kendriya Vidyalaya. So you have the one such picture of the project, which you can see here. Do a similar wallpaper project about any issue connected with the working of your state government, like an education program, any law and order issue, midday meal scheme, etc. So here you can see various topics which is given to you people. So you can also make the project. They have given the topic like education program. Recently we can say that the education policies has been changed. So on that you can make the project. Any law and order issues, midday meal scheme, etc. So you can also make the project on midday meal scheme. And see, let me tell you good things about the project, because we also do many times at school. What is the procedure of the project making? That first of all, you will be given the topics. You can select your own topics, right? The teacher will give you a list of topics. For example, you have 10 topics. Then your teacher will divide you. For example, you have 20 students. So they will make group as per the strength of the students, and then your teacher will tell you to select the topic. Afterwards, what is your next task is to discuss with your group members that tomorrow which kind of material you have to bring at school to make the project. So one student will bring the chart paper, the other will take the bring the pictures also, and the other students will bring the sketch pens and colors and pencil and scale and everything. then you people have to meet prior that what are you going to present on the chart paper, which kind of drawings or cuttings you are going to paste, or what will be your heading or your topic, and how you are going to explain with the help of the diagram or whatever you want to do on this. So many skills are required, because you you need to delegate the work, who is good at the handwriting, who is good at drawing. So the student who is good at drawing, he has to do the drawing, whose handwriting is good will write on the chart paper. Then the main part comes here. After completion of the project, you have to also decide that who is going to speak in front of the class, in front of the teacher, or maybe in front of the entire school, right? And you have to go as per the topic, one by one, whatever your sub points are, and you have to explain each and every point effectively, so that other students who are listening can get your concept in a proper way. And after the completion of your project, you can also tell to the other students that if you have any query or doubt, you can ask us. We are here to give the answers. And this is the entire way to make a nice, attractive project. So that was all about the project. And here we have some of the definitions given. So this is important, so let us discuss that, and I'll give you the worksheet as well, that also you have to write it down in your notebook. Constituency. What is constituency? A particular area from which all the waters living there choose their representative. A particular area from which all the waters living over there choose their representatives. This could be, for example, a panchayat ward or an area that chooses an MLA. Majority. What is majority? This is a situation when more than half the number in a group supports a decision or an idea. This is called a simple majority. We are just repeating this thing so that you can have revision of these definitions. Then we have opposition. This refers to elected representatives who are not members of the ruling party. It's very easy. They are not the members of the ruling party, and they are the other members, and who play the role of questioning government, like you have not done this project, or you have not taken care of about this issue or problem. So opposition party can ask questions to the ruling party and actions as well as raise new issues for consideration in the assembly. Press conference. A gathering of journalists from the media who are invited to hear about and ask questions on a particular issue, and are then expected to report on this to the larger public. So this is the task of actually journalist whose work is to ask question, and they are being called and they can ask questions, and in front of the public the ministers or the analysts have to give the answer, or the other people who are connected with this work. Okay, so here our chapter gets over. It was actually very easy chapter to understand about the legislative assembly, about the minister, about the constituency, right, about the MLA. So I hope you understood everything properly.